Maybe you saw the news item some time back about a Canadian farmer who sold his Stradivarius violin for, I think it was in the neighborhood of $60,000. He sold it to the same New York City dealer he had bought it from many years before. The dealer paid him more for it than he had paid, and that's because, of course, the violin had appreciated in value over the years and because of the shrinking buying power of the dollar. But the farmer sold his precious violin by the world's most famous violin craftsman because, as he put it, I'm getting old and I have no children to leave it to. And by getting it back in the hands of the dealer, he knew that it would wind up with someone who would treasure it as he had. Antonio Stradivari, the Italian violin maker, lived from 1644 to 1737. That's 93 years at a time when the average life span was about 30. He worked alone, although later in his life his sons helped him. No committee advised him, no one made decisions for him. His tools were primitive, but that was not important. He put himself into his work. All the world's tools couldn't make up for that. When he was finished with an instrument, when he was sure that his work measured up to his own personal standards, he signed his name to it. And today, more than 200 years later, his name is a household word all over the world. Everybody's heard of Stradivarius, the Latin form of the name that he inscribed on his violins. Throughout history, there have always been men with similar standards of excellence. Authors such as William Shakespeare, artists like Leonardo da Vinci, craftsmen like furniture maker Thomas Chippendale and silversmith Paul Revere. Everything they did was done well, not because it had to be, but because they wanted it to be. They had only to please themselves, yet the products of their fertile minds and skillful hands are still collected and admired today. What is it that causes one person to take pride in what he does while others give little or no thought to the quality of their work at all, do you know? Of course, when we talk about Stradivari or Da Vinci, we're talking about great geniuses, towering talents who found their media and became great in them. There have been many other fine violin makers and artists who took just as much pride and care in their work but lacked the same quality of talent. There are even today many thousands of craftsmen who will not turn out shoddy work and who are proud to sign their names to their creations. They're in the minority, perhaps. They've always been in the minority. But the respect for quality never changes. It still commands the highest price. It's still revered wherever we find it. And the person creating it has gained for himself two precious assets. First, he's built the kind of security that lasts a lifetime. He need never worry about his income. And second, his work is a source of satisfaction and joy to him. He derives deep satisfaction from being an uncommon person. And now a moment for this message. People who set their own high standards to which they make themselves measure up lead enjoyable, exciting lives. Each task they begin is a fascinating contest to achieve their own standards of excellence. Thank you.